stupid simple rigger. And when I do, I'll squeal on him so loud.
Wow, you're mad, Charlie. Should I like to be around and catch up with that fellow?
Well, it won't be on this trip. Not in Iowa. Even the great Professor Hill couldn't sell them neck-bowed Hawkeyes out here. Or,
gentlemen, you intrigue me. I think I'll have to give Iowa a try.
Don't believe I caught your name. Don't believe I don't.
Besides, we got a stuck-up music teacher here who'll expose you
before you get your grip on cats.
Male or female?
The music teacher? Well, she's the librarian. Female.
Perfect! That's just what I wanted to hear. If you see her, be sure to point her out to me.
I will. So, how are you gonna start your pitch?
Same old way. Keep that music teacher off balance, and my next step will be to get your town out of the serious trouble it's in.
River City isn't in any trouble.
Then I'll have to create some. I have to create a desperate need for a boys' band. You remember? Now, what's new around here? What can I use?
Nothing. Except the billiard parlor's just put in a new pool table.
They never had a pool here before.
No, only billiards.
That'll do. Oh, see you later, Mars. And remember, music teacher.
Music teacher.
Ah, you're Mr. Dunlop.
Yep.
Either you're closing your eyes to a situation you do not wish to acknowledge, or you are unaware of the caliber of disaster indicated by the presence of a pool table in your community. Well, you got trouble. Right here, I said trouble, right here in River City. Why, sure, I'm up here, player sitting mighty proud to say I'm always mighty proud to say it. I consider that the hours I spend with a cue in my hand, the goal is, I'll be cultivating horse sense and a cool head and a keen eye. Did you ever take a try to give an ironclad lead to yourself on a three-rail shot? But just as I say it takes judgment, brains and maturity to score in a ball-flying game, I say that any boot I can take and shove a ball in a pot. And I call that slot the first big step on the road to the depths of every day. I say first, medicinal wine from a teaspoon, then beer from a bottle. And the next thing you know, the sun is laying for plenty of payback. And I listen to some big out-of-town gossip, hearing tell about horse race scams. Not a wholesome front race, no, but a race where they sit down right on the horse. Like to see some stuck-up jockey boy sitting on Dan's back. Makes your blood boil, well, I should say. Now, friends, let me tell you what I mean. Yep, one, two, three, four, five, six. Pockets in the table. Pockets to mark the difference between a gentleman and a bum. With a kind of no fee in that rhyme, just pee in that stands for cool. And all week long, your River City youth will be twittering away. I say your young men be twittering. Twittering away their noontime, summertime, short time too. Get the ball in the park. Never mind hitting dandelions, border and swing door, catch for the beef steak pounding. Never mind pumping any water till your parents are caught with a sister and empty on a Saturday night. That's so old, yes, you got lots and lots of trouble. I'm talking about the kids in the Knickerbocker, shirt-tailed young ones, peeking in the pool hall when that was where you got trouble. Right here in River City. They leave the pool hall, heading for the dance of the harbor. Libertine men, scarlet women, and ragtime. Shameless music that'll drag your son and your daughter into the arms of the jungle. Animal instinct, mad hysteria. Friends, idle brain is the devil's playground. Trouble!
Oh, we got trouble!
Right here in River City.
Right here in the city.
We got a little key in that rhyme, we're seeing that dance.
That's dance.
We truly got trouble.
We truly got trouble.
Right here in River City.
Right here.
Gotta figure out a way to get the young ones moral at school.
Our children's children.
Mothers of River City, heed the warning before it's too late. Watch for the telltale signs of corruption. The moment your son leaves the house, does he rebuckle his knickerbockers below the knee? Is there a nicotine stain on his index finger? A dime now hidden in the corn crib? Is he memorizing jokes out of Captain Billy's whiz bag? Are certain words creeping into his vocabulary? Words like swell and soldier old man. If so, my friends, get to him.
Oh, get to him.
Right here in River City.
Right here in River City.
We have an old tea in that pot and just pee in that tank. The main Plymouth Rock and the Golden Rule.
Our children's gonna have trouble.
Oh, we got trouble. We're in terrible, terrible trouble. That game with the 15 number balls is the devil's tool. Oh, yeah, we got trouble, trouble, trouble.
That your daughter?
Yes, Mama. Keep on, Amaryllis. I'll be there in a minute.
Not Winthrop, there'll be someone else.
Never! I'll end up an old maid like you.
you. I'm sorry, Miss Marion. Can I play my crosshand piece?
May I play?
May I play my crosshand piece?
You may.
See, without a sweetheart, you'd have no one to say goodnight to on the Evening Star.
I know, Amaryllis. So for the time being, just say goodnight, my someone. You can put the name in when the right someone comes along.
All right, it's better than nothing.
Yes, it is. Now you can play your crosshand piece.
Now I may play my crosshand piece.
Good night, my someone, sleep tight, my
until we get this pool table matter settled.
Thank you.
for me to who laid the rails. Hill, I'll talk to you about this bank thing Monday morning over to City Hall, 10 o'clock sharp. I want that spellbinder for dentists.
Constable, I'll be responsible for the boy.
You don't know this kid, Professor. He's tough. Probably got a gangway around the corner for him.
Don't worry. I'll be careful. Tommy, I'd like to talk to you about the band.
Aw, oh, gee, Professor, that's a little kid.
I'm not talking about you playing in the band. You're mechanically minded, aren't you? Ever do anything with perpetual motion?
Nearly had it a couple times.
You did? You're my man! Do you realize that nobody has ever invented a music holder for a marching piccolo player? No place to hang the music.
Gee, Lee Clyde, wonder I could get some wire from!
Look in your cellar, that's where people keep wire. Tommy.
Yes, sir?
Now, Constable, I'll show you how to break up a gang. Oh, young lady. Oh, miss. What's your name?
Zanita. I didn't have any idea you were special as me. Thank God.
Do you know Tommy Jewis?
Well,
Tommy! This is Zanita. Escort the young lady home.
Only, except that I'm not going home. I have to go to the library. Thank God.
Then escort the young lady home by way of the library. By way of the, candy kitchen.
Yes, sir. Do I have to?
You have to.
Yes, sir.
Yes, God!
Oh, Professor. Now, you're a pretty bright fellow. You made a couple of mistakes, though.
Oh?
The mayor happens to own that billiard parlor. And the new pool table.
Oh. What was my other mistake?
That Anita? She's the mayor's oldest girl.
We're in the school board.
Academics are typical.
Nothing of the kind.
We need letters and papers.
Make it put up a bond.
What am I hearing?
Say ice cream.
Ice cream, but I don't sing.
All right, talk then.
Don't hear ice cream.
Talk slow.
Ice cream.
See? Singing is only sustained talking.
Now you right here,
ice cream.
Now you, sir,
ice cream.
Now you, sir,
ice cream.
Ladies, from now on, you'll never see one of those men without the other three.
Oh, Professor, you're wrong. Why, they hated each other for 15 years.
Ice cream.
Around wherever I go. And another thing, Mr. Hill,
possibly mesmerized or hoodwinked as some people in this town, and I find it only fair to warn you that I have a shelf full of reference books in here which may very well give me some interesting information about you.
Hey, Gregory.
Hi, Mars.
Don't call me Greg.
So, how'd you make out with that music teacher?
Scrumptious. Ate out of my hand the minute I took my hat.
She did? Boy, did you cut a swath tonight. For a minute, even I thought you knew something about leading the band. Like when you used to imitate that band concert fella, back in Joplin.
Yeah. Oh, kid stuff. I'm in rare form these days, son. Just you keep your eyes on me for the next 4 weeks.
4 weeks? But it only used to take 10 days for the instruments to arrive.
It still does. But it takes 4 weeks for the uniforms.
Oh, no, Greg, you haven't had uniforms.
Uniforms and instruction books.
Instruction books? But you can't pass yourself off as no music professor. I mean, not for any 4 weeks.
Morse?
But you don't know one note from another.
I have a revolutionary new method called the Think System, where you don't bother with notes. Oh, this is a refined operation, son. I've got it timed right down to the last wave of the brakeman's hand on the last train out of town. Now, Mr. Washburn, if you'll excuse me.
Gonna line yourself up a little canoodling, huh?
Well,
say, I can fix you up with Ethel's sister. She's a lovely girl. She teaches Sunday school.
No wide-eyed, wholesome, innocent Sunday school teacher for me. That kind of girl spins webs no spider ever. Listen, boy. A girl who trades on all that purity merely wants to trade my independence for her security. The young person she looks pursuit marching down the aisle. No golden, glorious, gleaming Christian goddess. No sir, or no Diana do I play on. I can tell you that right now. I snarl, I think, how can ignorance be compared to risk? I fizz for the lady who knows what time it is. I cheer, I rave for the virtue I'm too late to save. A sadder but wiser girl for me. No wide-eyed wholesome innocent Josephine. No sir, well she's the fisherman, I'm the fish you've seen. I've heard you take a on a more adult romance. No, young all the time she keeps insisting. No wide-eyed wholesome innocent female. No sir, well she's the fisherman, I'm the fish, you see. I flinch, I shy when the delicate air goes by. I smile, I grin when the gal with the touch of steam walks in. I hope, I pray for Hester to win just one more egg.
Will you?
very young. Anyone can make a mistake.
What mistake?
No apologies, no explanations, please. I'll only be in town a short while, and the sound of it why the girl for me.
Will you please make your selection and
leave? I am.
Well, what do you want to take out?
The library.
Why, please.
The library. You're not listening, Marion. Look. Marbles. Six Steelies, eight Aggies, a dozen Kiwis, and one big platter with an American flag in the middle. I think I'll drop them.
No!
Madam Librarian. One kiss, my dear, to catch your ear. I love you madly, madly, Madam Librarian. Marion, heaven help us, the library caught on fire. And the volunteer old brigade man, and he whispered the news. Madam Librarian, what did I say, my dear, to make it clear? I need you badly, badly, Madam Librarian. Marion, if I stumble and I busted my watch in my collet, I can lie on your floor and notice my body had turned to dust. Madam Librarian, now lies a man who sits in the moonlight, and a fellow would know that his dog. for the civilized world accepts. And he's talking out loud with them.
You can. Out of a crowd, I'd pick you for a hod carrying, clay pipe smoking, shamrock wearing, harp playing, maverick eating, pinching, terrace almond still singing Irishman. Pick on me, David. Where are you from, me boy?
Gary, Indiana.
I knew it. Get. Where did you say?
Gary, Indiana. In fact, Gary Conservatory was my alma mater.
Was she now?
Why, yes. Gold medal, class of 5. How'd I do, Miss Carew?
How do you do, Mr. Carew?
Of course. Carew. I thought the name sounded familiar. I tried to see you since the other night.
He wants the windup in the band.
We're not interested, Mama.
But Marion, the boy might have his father's musical gift. He does have my job, you know.
Oh, your husband musical? Well, I'd like to have a talk with him. I'm sure we can.
Do you burst in on everyone's home like this? Prying into personal affairs? We're not interested.
Marion!
Well, that's one for and one against. Now why not let the boy's father decide?
The boy's father is dead. Anything else?
But that's all the more reason why your brother should have something like this.
My brother is a 10-year-old problem child who can't understand why his father was taken away. Do you care to explain it to him? He's been brooding about it for 2 years now. And as to your musical trip, why don't you go into business with some nice carnival man who sells gold-painted watches and glass diamond rings?
Musical tricks? Miss Carew, I hardly... I get the feeling she likes the idea. Oh, a little cautious, perhaps, but I admire that in a woman. Just keep me alive. I'll be back later in the week.
Oh, Professor Hill, about to buy his measurements. I make all his clothes. Sleeve, 21. Waist, 18. Crouch, 14.
Fine, that's all I need. Now, I must get back to the hotel.
Oh, I do hope you'll excuse Marion. She's not real.
Oh, don't worry about a thing, Miss Carew. I'm sure that at heart, she's as lovely as yourself. Good day to you, Winifred.
Has he gone?
He has. And I hope not forever. Darling, don't you ever think of your future? Gary, Indiana, conservation class of 5. Now, darling!
Now, Mama. Surely a girl's future doesn't depend on encouraging every fast-talking, self-centered, woman-chasing traveling man who comes to town. And the fact that he claims his commodity is music does not, in this particular case, impress me.
All right, darling, all right. Only it's a well-known principle that if you keep the flint in one drawer and the steel in another, you'll never strike much of a fire.
Mama! Winthrop! Winthrop, I know you're in there.
Will you please go to the library and ask Miss Grubb to give you the book I set aside? It's the Indiana State Educational Journal, 1890 to 1910. It's a large, brown volume with black corners.
Do I have to?
You won't have to talk to anyone. Here, I've written it all down. Thank you, dear. Now, what are you up to? Why are you eating books at this hour?
I have a feeling that the Indiana Journal may help me poke some large holes in the professor's claims.
Well, I give up. At your age, if you don't mind my asking, what kind of white knight do you expect to come riding along?
Well, I'm not waiting for Luther Griner, who backs me into the ancient history shop every time he comes into the library.
He does?
Or Ed Gamut in that buggy of his, with the removable back seat. But I'm not waiting for a man in shining white armor, I...
My white knight, that a Lancelot, nor an angel with wings, just someone to love me, who is not ashamed of a few nice things. My white knight, what my heart would say if it only knew.
Thank you. Round one for you, Mr. Hill. But I better hear some fine attitude out of that horn in pretty short order, or else I'll see you in the grand jury or to the county seat. And now, Miss Mary, how about that horn?
I'm George, and with you.
You want your phraseology? Get along if you want to. I gotta get something from the librarian. How about that horn?
Ladies, dance can be meet Tuesday nights at the high school.
kid. There's a shin will have my head.
Mr. Washburn, where is child 5 orbit?
Well, if you think you can hold these kids back, you go right ahead.
Start it off, Mr. Washburn. When do you see the new step Professor Hill taught us?
What will it be?
As soon as I get these premises off my oldest
finds a footnote in the well one.
Professor Hill, I think Mayorshin has behaved abominably, and I think it was wonderful of you coming to Tommy's defense.
Oh, that was nothing.
Yes, it was.
Oh, no! A man can't dodge the issue every time at home. Personal risk is involved. What does the poet say? The brave, the coward dies 1,000 deaths. The brave man, only 500. On the other hand, the mayor was pretty mad on account of his billiard parlor. And I suppose a musical recommendation from a musical authority like yourself would help. But I didn't think of asking you to do a thing like that.
What, Professor Hill?
You would?
I'd be glad to. I just wish I was a little more informed. I've been wanting to talk to you about Winthrop's cornet.
His cornet? Mother of Pearl Keys.
I'm sure it's fine. But you see, he never touches it. The first week or so, he made a few experimental blasts, I guess you could say.
Yes. Yes. Blasts.
And he sings the minuet and gee-dee-da almost constantly.
La-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da. La-dee-da. La-dee-da.
But he never touches the cornet.
Well,
he says you told him it wasn't necessary.
Well,
tell me about some think system. If he thinks about the minuet and G, then he won't have to bother with the notes. Now, Professor,
Miss Marion, the think system is a revolutionary method, I'll admit. But so was Galileo's conception of the heavens. Columbus's conception of the air. Look. Bach's conception of the well-tempered clavicle. Now, I cannot discuss these things here in public. But if you'll allow me to call. When may I call?
Why, any night this week? Why, Missy Blue, you're kind of a little long to get out, aren't you, Missy?
Suggestion, I'll find. with yourself? Will you ever tell him? Won't you ever tell him? Ah, yes, I know. I'm fiddlesticks. Just open your mouth and let it come out.
No, Mama.
No, nothing. The next time he comes to call, you see him alone. And if you haven't got the gumption to tell him how you feel, like, well, there's nothing wrong with a lady like him.
Mama!
Where have you been?
Fishing?
Fishing?
With Harold.
You mean Professor Hill?
Mm-hmm.
And look, I still have some worms left.
Did you have a good time?
Grumpy. He told me all about his hometown, Gary, Indiana, and he said he'd take me there someday. And he even taught me a song that hardly has any S's in it. Gary, Indiana, Gary, Indiana.
Trouble there, girly girl.
I never met a man as self and
oh, boy.
That's something we're quite
different. Six real salesmen, I can tell you that. And they'll have a
What am I doing? I missed that train. I'll get back. And I got to leave word about that fella Hill.
Leave word with me.
Not on your chin time. How do I know you deliver these letters?
Try me. There's your train. Now run for it.
Why, you double-dealing little... Who do you think you're protecting? That guy's got a girl in every county in Illinois. And he's taking it away from every one of them. And that's 102 counties. Not to mention the hyena teachers like you he coaches up to keep their mouths shut. He's the one who's heard the last of me, girl.
At the least suggestion of the question, by the roadside holding in rooms the doubt, sweetheart, to my name. Good evening, Miss Marianne. By the roads now, everyone knows that I'm hoping you're the same. So here is my road song, not fancy or fun. By the roads, oh, won't you be
Marion, dear, who was you talking to? Why was that here?
Miss Carew. Top of the evening.
Miss Marion.
You and Marion come up and set. I've got some jelly on the stove.
There's no jelly on the stove, Mama.
Well, I'll put some on.
Shall we set, as your mother said?
Well, I don't...
You did ask me to call.
Did I? I didn't mean anything.
Now, Miss Marion, I'm not suggesting your invitation inferred anything but academic enlightenment. The think system? I've been by your house several times to try to explain it to you, but there always seem to be people around. Mostly ladies, I thought.
Yes. Mrs. Squires and several of the ladies.
Good. I wouldn't want anybody beating my time. You wouldn't? No, ma'am. Well, it's evidently not the convenient night. I'll see you at the social later.
Professor Hill, is it true that you've had 100? What I'm trying to say is...
Yes?
Is it really true you've developed a... think system?
Think system. The think system.
Yes!
It's really very simple. As simple as whistling. Now, nobody has to show you how to use your lips in whistling. You only have to think a tune here to have it come out clearly here. Now just try this yourself before you ask any questions.
I take your word.
Could we sit down?
Are all music teachers as dense as I am?
All music teachers?
I dare say you meet dozens, even 100.
Well...
And are they all as fascinated as I have been with...
Some more, some less. One young lady thought of the same system before I got to her town. She showed me a few refinements.
I see.
Have I said something wrong?
Please don't let me keep you, Professor Hill. You must have many more important things to do than to explain the think system to me.
Can't think of one.
And it must be very dull company for a man of your experience.
Now say, where'd you hear an idea like that?
One hears rumors of traveling salesmen.
Now, Miss Marion, you mustn't believe everything you hear. After all, one even hears rumors about librarians.
I suppose you're referring to Uncle Maddie.
Uncle Maddie?
Mr. Madison, my father's best friend. No matter what they say, he left me an assured job so Mother and Winthrop and I could have some security. Surely you don't believe
it. Of course not. That's exactly what I'm saying. And why do you think people start those rumors?
Narrow-mindedness. Jealousy. Jealousy mostly, I guess.
And jealousy, mostly, is what starts rumors about traveling salesmen. What have you heard?
Nothing about you personally. Just generally.
What have you heard generally?
Well, just that. But of course, it's
lead to, I mean, take you for instance. Your attentions to customers and of teachers, well, might easily be misinterpreted, mightn't they? No, honestly, mightn't they? And so, another salesman or somebody were jealous. Well, they could be downright lies now, couldn't they?
Welcome.
Rumors and things.
Why, of course.
It just proves you should never believe everything you hear, doesn't it? I mean, if you just discuss things.
Miss Marion, I would be delighted to discuss anything in the world with you. But couldn't we do it sitting down? You do sit, your knees bending on.
We could sit on the porch steps.
We could also sit on the large hollow log over at the footbridge.
I couldn't think of it. I've never been to the footbridge with a man in my life.
Just to talk.
Well, I've got to dress for the social
meeting. Then meet me there in 15 minutes.
I just can't. Please. Some other time. Maybe tomorrow.
My dear little librarian, pile up enough tomorrows, and you'll find you've collected nothing but a lot of empty yesterdays. I don't know about you, but I'd like to make today worth remembering.
Oh, so would I.
The footbridge, 15 minutes.
15 minutes. Mama!
What?
I just told Professor Hill I'd meet him at the footbridge in 15 minutes. Well, glory be in the saints, be praised. It works.
What does?
I've been using the thing system on you from the parlor.
Expect too much more. One can't expect a traveling film.
I know there have been many ports of call, and there will be many more. But that's no reason for me not to be grateful for what you left behind for me.
Marion.
With 110 that I modestly took my place as one and only bass, and I hopped up and down the square.
Thank you.
Don't you know that? You don't owe me a word. Not a word. Now please, hurry, please.
He isn't anywhere around here! Let's try down by the brick!
Oh, wait, Mark!
Whoa there, son.
I'm not your son. Leave me go.
Not till I talk to you for a minute.
I won't listen. You wouldn't tell me the truth anyway.
Would to?
Would not.
Would to? Tell you anything you want to know.
Can you lead a band?
No.
Are you a big liar?
Yes.
Are you a dirty, rotten crook?
Yes.
Leave me go, you big liar.
What? I told you the truth, didn't I? Now listen, I'm bigger than you, and you're going to get all this, so you might as well stop wiggling. Now there are two things you're entitled to know. One, you're a wonderful kid. I thought so from the first. That's why I wanted you in the band so you quit moping around feeling sorry for yourself.
What band?
I always think there's a band.
What's the other thing I'm entitled to know?
Well, to tell you the truth, the other thing isn't any of your business.
I wish you'd never come to River City.
No, you don't, Winthrop.
You believe him, sister?
I believe everything he ever said.
Well, he promised
us. I know he promised us. And it all happened just like he said. The lights, the colors and the symbols.
Where was all that?
In the way every kid in this town walked around here all summer. And looked. And acted. Especially you. And the parents, too. His mama wished she'd never come to River City.
Well, you do, don't you?
No, you don't. Now please go, Mary.
Go on, Professor. Hurry up.
I can't go with her. For the first time in my life, I got my foot caught in the door.
There was love.
Well, do you? Surely some of you ought to be grateful for what he brought to River City. And if so, I should think you'd want to admit it.
You're wasting a great deal of time here. If there's a person in this hall that doesn't believe that this man Hill should be tarred and feathered, well, let him stay.